Here I consider the potential energy of a bar that is being extended. And in doing so, I will draw on ideas that I discussed while considering the potential energy of a spring that is being extended. So here's a bar, and let's say it is being, it's simply supported over here, and I will apply a force F like that to extend the bar. And under the influence of that force, the bar is going to extend. So let's say it extends something like that. And I can neglect the, you know, for this discussion, I neglect the effect of the Poisson's ratio. So there's the force F. And that's, let's say that distance is D, using the same notation as for the spring. To see what is the potential energy stored in the bar, we have to look at the force in the bar versus extension, okay? Now, at equilibrium, right? So, as before, this is at equilibrium. And at equilibrium, the force in the bar, okay, let me call that F bar, is equal to the uniform stress in the bar times the cross-sectional area. Now, the uniform stress is equal to the strain times the Young's modulus, okay? Uniaxial state of stress, the simplest form, the simplest state of stress. So that's sigma times A. And epsilon is going to be just the D, the extension over the original length of the bar, which I'll denote as L. And I can write this as, I can rearrange and write this as EA over L times D. And then if I use the analogy with the spring, where the force in the spring is K times D, I can call this the stiffness of the bar, K bar. So if I plot, we love these plots, of course. So if I plot the extension as before versus the force in the bar, okay, I will initially, extension is zero, the force in the bar is zero at equilibrium. The extension is D, and the force is K bar times D. And as before, the area under this curve will give us the you know, the work that we can get out of the bar when we release it. So it's a measure of the potential energy in the bar. So we'll say pi for the bar is half K bar D squared, and then I have to subtract out, you know, the potential energy I have lost from the external force. So you can see how, you know, it mimics what we saw for the spring. And also keep in mind that if the force was in the opposite direction, if we were compressing the bar, we would still, you know, this would still be positive. You'd basically, if you compress it by an amount D, you will still get this, because the force in the bar opposes the direction of deformation. So there is, you know, again, elastic or strain energy stored in the bar. And this is again going to be negative, because the, yeah, though the force is in the other direction, it's moving in the direction of deformation, and so you've lost potential energy. So that's something to keep in mind. Now, we have set the stage to think about the potential energy for a truss, which is composed of multiple bars. That's coming up next.